Hi, Happy New Year, and welcome to Hope in the Bible. I'm Laura Cruz Colon, sitting in for Pastor Frank and Nancy Stagno of Trinity Independent Church, Assembly of God Church, located at 421 Ward Avenue in Mamaroneck, New York. Well, I really must say that it's a pleasure to be here once again, sharing the Word of God and what God has done for us in our lives with all of you. But before I get started with the show, I want to make mention of some of the ministries that we have available, starting with our Sunday worship at 10 o'clock. Monday night, we not only have prayer time, we also have group study. And on Tuesday, we have another study, another Bible study. And before I mention the other ministries, I just want to encourage all of you to consider coming to one of our worship services on Sundays at 10 a.m. It's really a powerful service. If you're in the area, please come and visit us. We would love to have you. Our study group on Monday night is a unique type of session. We all get together and everyone has the opportunity to just talk about what God has done for them in their lives. And there's a lot of questions flying all over the place that are being answered. And then on Tuesday night, we have a very intensive type of study that there's more one-on-one with a man of God, our brother Joe Gigliamo. And it's really, really a wonderful time to spend with the Lord. And it's really, really great. I just remember the days that I used to rather do something else rather than to go to Bible study. And today, Bible study is what I enjoy doing. We also have a miracle. We have a prayer line with Pastor Richard Smalley. And he can be reached at 914-574-7068. Pastor Smalley is available to anyone who needs prayer, who wants prayer, who could use prayer. He's a faithful man of God, and trust that his prayers do prevail much. Miracles. We always have this feeling that, you know, when something good happens, okay, it's not a miracle, but we do have miracles. We have experienced a lot of miracles in our church, and we would love for any of you who have had the experience of a miracle to share it with us. So please feel free to call us. We have a ministry of Bible questions. If you have any questions at all that we could answer for you, please feel free to give us a call. We can be reached at 914-381-0545. We also have free daily devotionals. These are amazing to work with because they give encouraging inspiration to people who sometimes just don't know where to turn to. And I tell you, the Word of God can be found not only in the Bible, but also in these daily devotionals. We also have a ministry which we call Movie Night, and it happens on the third Wednesday of every month. This month, it's going to be on January 20th. And I'm looking so forward to this movie night this month because it's about a very interesting character in the Bible. It's called the Book of Daniel. And, you know, Daniel was a young man who was caught up in a world where it was foreign to him. But what I admire most about Daniel is the peace that he was able to retain, the peace of God that he was able to retain, and the occurrences that happened in his life that today is still an inspiration to all of us who know the story of Daniel. So please come and join us. We not only have a free movie, but we also have free popcorn and we have free refreshments. You're all welcome to come. We also are a handicap accessible church. So, you know, no one is deprived of coming to our facility. Consider coming to one of our services, to one of our worship services, or one of our Bible studies, or just come and say hello to us. Well, tonight, I want to talk about what I call changes and choices. And, you know, it's ironic because recently my life has been filled with many changes that have forced me to make quite a few choices. But I guess that can be said of all of our lives. It is most definitely a very complicated world that we're living in today. It's filled with all kinds of negativeness all over us. People just not getting along, confusion. But sometimes, you know, I think about how great it would be if one could choose a particular time in their life that they considered the best time ever, whether it was back in the day when you all you had to worry about was playing with your friends or trying to decide what you were going to wear at for the next Saturday night party, or just hanging out on the beach and with your friends and trying to find out who was coming and who was not coming. And then take that time, the best time of your life, and just freeze it and stand still and just be in it forever. Sounds good, but not realistic. So we know we can't do that. But we can make choices. We can make good choices today, starting with accepting Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior. Why? Because He is the way, the truth, and the light. And you know, regardless of what anyone thinks, I truly believe that He is the only intercessor between me and God. Also, that's the reason why He came. He came for my salvation. He came for your salvation. He came to save us all, because God wants no one to perish. However, God has given us one thing, and that's free will. The free will to choose whether we stay with God or whether we don't. I've made my choice. And you know, one of the things that I know that I need to do is to start by putting on that full armor of God. I want to read from Ephesians 6:10, which clarifies for me the importance of having that armor of God on, not only in the morning when you get up, wear it through the night while you sleep, wear it all the time, 24/7, okay? Even when you shower, you should have that armor of God on. So here we go. Finally, be strong in the Lord and His might, and in His mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's schemes. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the powers of this dark world, and against the spiritual forces of evil in heavenly realms. Therefore, put on the full armor of God, so that when the day of evil comes, you may be able to stand your ground. And after you have done everything, to stand firm with the belt of truth buckled around your waist, with the breastplate of righteousness in place, and with your feet fitted with the readiness that comes from the gospel of peace. In addition to all this, take up the shield of faith with which you can extinguish all, not some, not a few, all the flaming arrows of the evil one. Take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the Word of God, and pray in the Spirit on all occasions with all kinds of prayers and requests. With this in mind, be alert and always keep on praying for all. Not just for your family, not for just your church family, not just for your community, but for the whole world, especially our enemies. You know, I have come to understand that Christianity isn't a narcotic that dulls you into obedience. It involves a battle. And I mean heavy duty battle. And that is why we must not feel despair if we are struggling. Because you see, to struggle does not mean that we are incorrigible. It means that we are alive, and what we need to do is to put on that whole armor of God, as God directed us through Paul's letter in Ephesians 6:10. You know, James in 5:16, okay, talks about the resurrection power, which we all know. I mean, us Christians know what resurrection power is. The prayer of a righteous man being powerful and effective. And that's very true. But Paul's prayer in Ephesians 1:17, 23 is a model. I've come to understand that it's a model for one of the most essential and important prayers we could ever pray, not only for ourselves, but also for our family, for our church family, our community, and in fact, the whole world. And you know, praying for one another is something we all should do, always. I'm going to read that prayer because it is a prayer that is very, very dear to my heart. So we're going to Ephesians 1:17. And this is Paul praying as he's in jail. So this man is incarcerated, but he may be in chains physically, but not in his mind. And in his mind, all he can do is think of God and think of the awesomeness and how God is, regardless of where he's at, God is there with him. And he understands this. And therefore, he's able to retain this peace that he has. And he's able to send this peace out to other people. Okay? I keep asking the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give you the spirit of wisdom and revelation so that you may know him better. I pray also that the eyes of your heart may be enlightened in order that you may know the hope to which he has called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance in the saints, and I in his incomparability, great power for us who believe. That power is like the working of his mighty strength, which he exerted in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him at his right hand in the heavenly realms. This was far above all rule and authority, power and dominion, every title that can be given, not only in the present age, but also in the one to come. And God placed all these things under his feet and appointed him to be head of over everything over the church, for the church, which is his body, which we are his body, okay? The fullness of him who fills everything in every way. When I read this letter, I mean, you have to read this over and over again, because every time you read it, you get something else from it, okay? I mean, we have an awesome God, and we need to understand that although he gives us free will, his wish for us is not to perish. He made the ultimate sacrifice for us. He sent his only begotten Son to die for our sins. And when I think of what Jesus did for me, what he withstood, what the pain, the suffering, I just can't imagine anything that I can do in turn for him, except to continuously worship him, to pray, to ask him for the wisdom that I need to be obedient to his calling in my life, and to pray for the ones that I love. And, you know, sometimes it's not easy to pray, and sometimes we have a hard time understanding that because we are going through trials and tribulations as we are here. But then I remember that, you know, although we are of this earth, we are in this world, we're not of the world. Once we commit our lives to Jesus Christ, we're no longer of this world. We belong to him. And, you know, if he is for me, then I have to know and understand that, okay, who can be against me? And even if arrows come, like they say in Psalms, you know, you can just stand there and arrows will come all over you. But you know what? God is my shield. He is my rock, and I will stand with him forever and ever. I wanted to encourage some of my family recently into understanding, you know, why I've made the choice that I have made, okay, about this walk that I have chosen to be in today. And some of them understood, all of them respect, okay? But what I want is for all of them to understand to its fullest so they too can enjoy, okay, what I am enjoying, this wonderful walk that I'm doing with the Lord. There's no greater thing in life than to be in God's presence. It's not an easy task sometimes because we are struggling with adversities that in the natural, you know, they may make sense to other people. But when you keep your faith and when you stand and you stand strong and you stand with that armor of God and you know that God is there, that he will always protect you, you know, there's a peace that comes from him that can't be explained. It's just that peace that passes all understanding. I myself don't understand it, but I do accept it and I do enjoy it. And I, you know, I wish that for everybody that I love and anybody that I come in contact with, I'm just so eager to share what God has done for me in my life, okay? It's not about, you know, making people, you know, believe in what I believe. It's about making people understand what God has done for me in my life. He has truly changed me. I have gone through a lot. I have had a lot of losses in my life. But you know what? I have come to understand that even if I lose everything, I mean everything, my children, my grandchildren, everything, and I have nothing, I know that I still have God. And I will always have God because he will always be there for me, just like he can be there for you. All you have to do is accept him in your heart. He will take you to places that you can't even imagine, like he's done me. I would like to read a little bit of a psalm that I have prepared for tonight because one of the things that I like and enjoy a lot when I study the Bible is the book of Psalms. The book of Psalms can do so much for you. It can bring you to an understanding that you can't even comprehend right now, but or may not be able to, like I wasn't able to at one time in my life. But every day, I make it my business to study or to read one psalm or another. And today, I want to read a little bit from, and I had it here, just a second. Okay, here we go. I love this book. This is like the book that I go to every single day before I do anything else. Okay. All right, so a lot of us, like myself, didn't understand, you know, a lot of things in the Bible, and this is why it's so important to go to Bible study so you can come to understand a lot of things that God wants us to understand. But Psalm 78, which is not a psalm that's always mentioned, but I like to read the psalms that are not always mentioned, okay? And I came to the psalm where it says, "O my people, hear my teaching. Listen to the words of my mouth, and I will open my mouth in parables. And I will utter hidden things, things from of old. And what we have heard and known, what our fathers have told us, will not hide them from their children." You know, I didn't understand that to its full context, but then one day I started to think about, oh my goodness, if I had only had the opportunity to know the Bible the way that I'm learning it now. I'm not a Bible scholar of any sorts, but I am familiar with the Bible now. to me, this is my lifeline, because this is the word of God. And I wish to encourage all of you to make an effort to every day pick up this Bible and just go to it. Even if you start with the book of Psalms, whatever. I mean, there's no rule, okay? There's no rule of how to read the Bible. Wherever you go in the Bible, you're going to learn something. You're going to acquire something. God is going to tell you something. God is going to show you something. Wherever in the Bible you go, whether it be in the Old Testament or the New Testament. And, you know, I myself, okay, I'm guilty of not reading a lot of books that I just didn't understand. So to me, I just classified them as boring. But there's not one book in this Bible that is boring. Every book, there's a meaning. I mean, there's a significance in every book. And it's so real. When you start reading this Bible, sometimes I feel like I'm back there in those days. And I wish I was sometimes, because they were totally different than what we have now. Not different in the sense of the chaos and the complications that we have, because, you know, that goes to show you that from the beginning of time, God has been a very patient father with all of his children. And, you know, it's been a long, long struggle for God, but I'm happy to say that we're in the end times. So I realize now that what is happening is that we are here, and we're supposed to be getting ready for our eternal place. And this is why it's important to read this Bible. This is why it's important to study this Bible. This is why it's important to understand what God is telling us. We have to prepare the way for the Lord. He's coming soon, and there's no doubt about it. And for all of you who do not understand this, I hope that one day you might be encouraged, whether it be through listening to me or listening to someone else, to at least try and find out what God is really telling us. I know for me, it's been an awakening experience. You know, through all the losses that I've had in the past few years, I've come to understand that, hey, there's no greater loss than losing my God. And I know that, you know, regardless of how my struggles have been, God has always been there for me. And I thank him for this. And I want to encourage you to consider allowing him to do the same thing for you that he has done for me. Perhaps one day we'll see you at the church. We welcome everybody. We are a church that believes that Jesus Christ is Lord, and everybody is somebody. You know, and you are somebody. I'm somebody. You know why? Because God makes no junk. Don't submit yourself to the evils of this world, okay? They will take you nowhere except to the darkness, darkest place you will ever, ever imagine, you could ever imagine going. But remember this, that God gives us the opportunity to come to him, and while you still have that opportunity, consider taking it. God loves you like he loves me, like he loves all of us. I hope that my babbling tonight will come to someone's attention. I ask God to help me to deliver, okay, the message that he wants me to deliver, to help you understand that we are in the end times, and we need to understand this, because once the end times are over and Jesus Christ comes, then it's going to be too late. We have to make it our business to encourage all of our friends, all of our families, all the people in this world that don't know the Lord to at least consider coming to the Lord. He loves you. Give him an opportunity. He will definitely change your life. Now, before I close, I want to encourage you again, invite you again to come to our movie night. You can start by seeing this movie, The Book of Daniel. This will definitely give you an insight as to what God is doing in our lives at Trinity Independent Assembly of God Church. In closing, I would like to say, remember, I'm not making no New Year's resolutions. I'm making a commitment to get closer to my God by studying His Word more, by being obedient to what He's calling me to do. You can do the same. And remember always that there is hope in the Bible. I thank you for allowing me to come into your homes tonight. Good night.